On the morning of September 11th, I got an emergency call from Jalalabad with the news of the terrorist attacks in the US. The TV news carried tense reports about a relatively unknown country, Afghanistan.
Every nation.
President Bush declared America is strong and called for retaliation to the applause of the American people.
Or you are with the terrorists.
It seemed that people were possessed by something. Our civilization had lost its moral compass. That made me extremely sad.
A Japanese doctor has engaged in medical practice in Afghanistan for many years. Dr. Tetsu Nakamura. In 2001, Afghanistan faced a drought of historic proportions, which devastated the country's agriculture. There were food shortages. Hunger and thirst took the lives of many people. Nakamura took off his white doctor's coat and took on the construction of an irrigation canal that would bring water to the parched soil.
American helicopters often pass over the areas where we are working. They employ oppressive machines, while we have the dusty shirts on our backs. We know the feelings of those who exult when the parched land obtains water.
Sixteen years later, the parched, barren plains have been transformed into a green, fertile land. This is the story of the physician Tetsu Nakamura, who continued to battle drought as the flames of war continued to burn in Afghanistan. We first filmed Nakamura's work in 1998. Nakamura was then attempting to build a new clinic in a mountainous region of Afghanistan.
Once we start something, this would be a permanent base.
Beginning in 1991, Nakamura opened three clinics in this area where he provided medical services. However, his efforts soon ran into a major barrier. In the summer of 2000, a succession of children were brought to Nakamura with serious symptoms.
Yes.
The source of the problem was the historic drought that afflicted Afghanistan. Throughout the area, wells for drinking water had gone bone dry. People crowded around wells that still produced water, and fights ensued. In the midst of this crisis, the 9/11 terror attacks in the U.S.
Also attacks on the southern city of Kandahar, also attacks on the eastern Afghan city of Jalalabad.
Nakamura and his staff evacuated to Pakistan, where Nakamura wrote the following account of his feelings.
Freedom and Democracy is now conducting a large-scale murderous war in reprisal for terrorism. In all likelihood, the sight of the mounds of corpses of innocent people will cause pain and bad dreams of regret for the revenge takers themselves. As the world's great powers coalesce around this small dying country, I am left with a simple doubt. What are they trying to protect?
In the area near Pakistan's border, Afghan civilians who had fled the bombing flooded the refugee camps. When Nakamura returned to Afghanistan, he saw that the damage caused by the drought had grown more severe. The farmland of Nangarhar province, which had once been a fertile breadbasket, was now void of any crops. Throughout the country, some 4 million people stood on the brink of starvation. Food and water were essential to Afghanistan's recovery. Nakamura now made a firm decision to shed his doctor's coat and to start building an irrigation canal. Nakamura identified the Kunar River, one of Afghanistan's few large rivers, as the water source for his irrigation canal. With its headwaters among glaciers and 7,000-meter-high mountains, the river flows year-round, even in times of drought.
Actually, this is a wrong map, yeah. And saying that we can get the water rather this side.
If water could be drawn from the Kunar River to the parched fields, perhaps agriculture could be revived. Nakamura began to develop construction plans. However, he had absolutely no knowledge of civil engineering or irrigation.
In that speed, Dr. Saib, that sand and mud will not go down, yes. That is good for interval for us. Yes.
I'm a doctor, medical doctor.
Consulting Japanese documents, he drafted a plan on his own.
Structures. This is one of the difficult.
Yes.
The goal for the first 2 years was to build a 12-kilometer long canal.
I think we are making 100% the perfect ones. It will take 5, 6, 7 years, I am sure. So the idea is speaking, the sooner the better. First bring the water to call them back.
Yes. Nakamura's vision. A project to turn the parched land green again. Drawing water from the Kunar River, the canal will traverse parched land and finally arrive at the Gambari Desert. If it is completed, it will irrigate 3,000 hectares of farmland and support the livelihood of 100,000 people. Some members of the Afghan staff raised doubts about what appeared to be a foolhardy plan. But Nakamura's commitment did not waver.
You people, every day, hundreds of children are expiring. And as well as so many people are suffering from the diseases because of the shortcoming of the borders. Just our target is the lives of the people itself. So the success of this canal project, as well as dam project over there, is the key for our future.
March 2003, the irrigation project was launched. Funding was provided by Peace Japan Medical Services, an NGO that supports Nakamura's activities. Local farmers saw a ray of hope in the prospect of reviving their fields, and they came forth to help. Day by day, the number of participating farmers grew. The word spread. People who had taken shelter in refugee camps began to travel long distances to help. The workers are paid a daily stipend worth about $2.50. For these men who are unable to farm because of the drought, this is the sole source of support for their families. Nakamura began work on construction of the intake at the mouth of the canal. The intake is where water is drawn from the river into the irrigation canal. If it is not built properly, water will not flow into the system. To draw water into a canal, it is necessary to build a structure in the river. This changes the flow of the water, making it enter the canal. This structure is called a weir. Nakamura first undertook the construction of a levee upriver from the canal intake. When the levee is built, the river will flow on the far side of the island, keeping water out of the sight for the weir. This will make it easier to construct the weir. Truckloads of soil and rock are dumped into the river. 20 meters to reach the island. Then, unexpectedly, the levee could be extended no further. No matter how much soil is dumped, the current carries it away. As the gap between the levee and the island narrowed, the flow of the river increased beyond expectations. Nakamura tried another approach. Concrete frames, weighing a total of 800 kilograms. Faced with the overwhelming potency of nature, Nakamura was forced to rethink his plans. The plans called for the intake to be completed by the following spring. Just 2 months remain. When spring comes, the snowmelt from the mountains will begin to flow, increasing the strength of the current. This would result in costly delays to the construction. Meanwhile, work on reinforcing the banks of the canal continues. Nakamura employs gabions to protect the banks from the pressure of the water. This is a traditional technique that has been used in Japan for reinforcement for hundreds of years. It is a simple structure with rock lining a cage made from metal wire. But the result is as strong as concrete. One major advantage of this technique is that it only requires wire and rock, so when the cage fails, it can easily be repaired. Nakamura employed these traditional techniques so the local people themselves will be able to maintain the irrigation canal in the future. Around this time in Afghanistan, the Taliban began to reassert itself, and security in the countryside deteriorated. In Nangarhar province, where Nakamura was working, clashes between the Taliban and the US military were frequent. The armored vehicles of American forces attempting to quell terrorist attacks often passed by the construction site, raising anxiety among the workers. On one occasion, an American helicopter suddenly opened fire on Nakamura and his team.
Afterwards,
the U.S. military acknowledged the mistaken attack and apologized. Even in the midst of warfare, the fight against the drought continues. Despite the brutal sun that pushed the heat past 40 degrees Celsius, Nakamura can depend on the Afghani men continuing to work. Former anti-government fighters and mercenaries who fought with American forces joined the efforts, exchanging their rifles for pickaxes.
کاینده که موږ د خپل همت په ضرور دینو چې کوم خپل همت وکړو خپل وطن جوړ کو خپل کور جوړ کو خپل یار دوست ګټه ورسو خپل وطن دار ته ګټه ورسو نور خپل پردی ته ګټه ورسو خپل
او دا خلک ټول بی زمينه دي چې کوم څوک څه زما کتل تلری نو هغه غونډه للمی ده او بل د موږ بشان د غریب خلکو کار مرته کیږي پاکستان ته بتل لته به مزدوری نه کولې بیا راتل دلته بال بچ مشومان به ټول دلته
まあ、極端な話がこの今治安が悪いと言ってますけれども泥棒に入る人だって強盗に入る人だって別にこの遊び金が欲しいわけじゃないんですね家族を食わせるがためにこの、人のものに手を出したり、それから傭兵になって米軍の傭兵になったりあるいはこのタリバン派反タリバン派の軍閥の傭兵になったりしてですね食わざるを得ない、まあ、そういう事態は、まあ、やむを得ず、まあ、そうするけれども決して誰も望んでないわけですね。ともかく平和に家族がみんなに一緒に折れてそして、まあ、飢饉に出会わずに安心して食べていけることというのが、この何よりも大きな願いというか望みじゃないですかね。
How to proceed with construction of the canal intake, given the strong currents of the Kunar River. Nakamura discovered the answer to his problem in Fukuoka, his home prefecture in Japan. The Amada Weir, completed over 200 years ago, it has survived in the swift currents of the Chikugo River to this day, diverting a steady stream of water into an irrigation canal throughout the year. How was such a weir constructed in an era before there was heavy construction equipment? This drawing was made during the Edo period, when the Amada Weir was under construction. The tip of the weir extends diagonally from the intake into the river. This was the secret that made it possible to build the weir directly in the swift current of the river, without constructing a levee that blocked the river's flow. If the weir is built perpendicular to the flow, it receives the full force of the river and is in danger of breaking apart. But if the weir is built diagonally, it diverts the water resistance, which makes it possible to complete the structure. Nakamura resumed construction of the weir. Following the design of the Yamada weir, these boulders were placed at a diagonal angle to the flow of the river. Even in the rapid current, the weir grows in size. One month after construction began, the project faces a major hurdle. The weir must be extended into the deepest part of the river. A specially selected huge boulder is put in place. The boulder disappears under the surface of the water. The river is easily over 5 meters deep at this spot. Too big to be lifted by the bulldozer, was pushed from the hills 16 kilometers away and finally rolled into place. It weighs about 5 tons. Finally, the boulders break the surface of the water. The deepest part of the river has been filled, and the weir has reached its projected size. The diagonal weir now reached 220 meters into the Kunar River.
Meherbani, singe, jore, karari da.
2 months after the plans were revised, the intake was completed just before the seasonal snowmelt would flood the river. Now came the moment to see if this weir would divert water from the river into the irrigation canal. One year after construction began, 1.6 kilometers of the canal have been dug. Nakamura decided to test the flow of water. The water flows, irrigating the parched soil.
Oi, mini, oi, there.
In the hopes that it'll become a beautiful canal flowing through the wasteland, Nakamura dubbed it the Mawarid Irrigation Canal, using the Dari word for pearl. The next day. The canal wall breached at a point 1.2 kilometers from the intake. It was a spot along the river where a landfill berm had been constructed. Local villagers heard about the breach and hurried to the scene. They wasted no time getting to work.
I watched in amazement. They had an instinctive sense of where the earthen wall was weak, and they knew how to repair it. From their childhood, they had a grasp of the nature of the soil and the flow of water, and I realized they had mastered the art of living in this arid climate. The remarkable intuition and perseverance of the local farmers gave me great confidence about carrying forward with our work.
Construction continued over the years that followed, and water flowed into the canal as segments were completed. Seven years later, the irrigation canal finally reached its goal, the Gomberi Desert. A total length of 25 kilometers of canal had been completed. Nakamura planted willow trees on both banks of the canal. The roots of the willows intertwined with the rocks of the gabions and, holding fast, served to reinforce the walls. Beside the murmuring stream, the cool shade of the trees spread. And then, spring. Along the course of the canal, wide expanses of wheat fields grew. The plain that had been parched from drought was transformed into a broad vista of green fields. People who had fled their homeland began to return in a steady stream. Fall comes and crops ripen. Waves of golden grain cover what had been the barren ground of the Gamberi Desert. The men who had joined in the construction of the irrigation canal were now hard at work harvesting rice.
What will we pass on to future generations? Now, as the desert becomes green fields, trees grow lush and dense. Sheep laze along the riverbank. Fruit ripens in profusion. For all living things to live in peace, that is the undeniable evidence of bounty. This may be a small corner of the earth, but I am grateful for the opportunity to witness it.
Nakamura then turned to a new project, responding to the villagers' earnest request to build a certain facility. This was a religious complex, including a mosque, a Muslim place of worship, and a madrasa, a Muslim religious school. To the people of Afghanistan, a mosque is a place of worship, as well as a place of spiritual support. People gather there, and sometimes disputes among villagers are resolved. It functions as the core of the local community. Around this time, the U.S. military suspected mosques and madrasas of incubating terrorists. But Nakamura did not hesitate to respond to the requests of the local population.
やっぱり地元の人たちが元気が出るにはというのはありましたよね。人肌抜きましょうかというのは。
2 years after construction began, in a village halfway along the 25-kilometer route of the irrigation canal, a large mosque with a capacity of 800 people opens its doors. About 600 students attend the madrasa. The classes are free. In addition to Islam, the school teaches standard subjects such as reading, writing, and mathematics. This was a language class for third grade students.
Mind the
Word by word, the children learned about dangers in the world around them. A ceremony was held to celebrate the completion of the irrigation canal, the mosque, and the madrasa.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. خداي پټول ننګارانو پورې پټول افغانان پر د خیر کې کوره ودان کوره ودان
آمين.
Nakamura turned over the operation of the mosque and the madrasa to the local population.
Zindabad.
Twelve years have passed since construction of the irrigation canal began. The Mawarid Irrigation Canal has been extended further and now covers a distance of 27 kilometers. The Gamberi Desert, which was called the Valley of Death, where not a single tree grew, has been reborn as a vast plain of green. In addition to the Mawarid Irrigation Canal, Nakamura has built or restored irrigation canals in 8 places. The canals have irrigated fields across a total area of 16,000 hectares. The water supports the livelihood of 600,000 people.
کار ټول خلک کوي خو داسې رښتیا باندې کار نه کوي صداقت مننه تشکر دعا درته کوو کامیابی دې وړو
دربارې دا وګوره چې اوس دا خلکو ته د اوبو نشته دی د پیسې نشته دی و د خوراک نشته دی دا اول ځوندوم پکړی ځوندوم پکړی توپک موپک نه پکړی کنه دا ځوندوم پکړ دی کنه دا زما طریقه دی چې دغه شند کومک نه دا دا راتورون کنه دا جاری ساتو کنه.
Food processing has begun in the villages. In a factory, sugar is refined from cane grown in the new fields. Brown sugar, which was once a product of the region, reappears after a long absence.
Sweet. Very sweet.
Dairy farming has also been revived. Production of cheese and other dairy products has begun. Now, on weekends, a market has opened, making the streets a lively scene once again. Many of the villagers in this region appreciated how the irrigation canal had improved security and brought peace to the area.
ارزه ته ورسیږي گمبيري ته ورسیږي خلک چې خپل روزګار ته گرفتار شي وځي څنګه کوم چې د جنگ ته ځم چې خپل روزګار سره بند يم او چې سړی وږی شو هغه حتمن یو ډډې ته وځي هغه د پیسو د خپل خېټې د باره ځي جنگ ته چې خېټه ماړه شو نور سوچ څنګه چې جنگ دی.
Thank you.
16 years have passed. Having shed the white coat of a doctor, Nakamura assessed the vision he had pursued.
This is not a peace movement. It is an extension of medicine. And the extension of medicine is how many people will be saved. And in that regard, as a result, 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 争い事が少ない、治安がいい、麻薬が少ないということが言えるわけで、これが平和への一つの道であるという主張は私したことは少ないと思います。ただ戦をしてる暇はないんですよと、その戦をするとこういう状態ますます悪くなるんですよ。でそれにはやっぱり平和なんですよ。でそれは結果として得られた平和であって、
However, those who benefit from the irrigation canals are no more than 2% of the population of Afghanistan. The United Nations estimated that in 2014, one-third of the population faced food shortages because of the drought. Now, in Afghanistan, security has deteriorated as terrorist attacks by anti-government insurgents have become more frequent. Coalition forces led by the U.S. have attempted to counter the spread of the insurgency with military force. 16 years after the 9/11 terrorist attacks, there is still no end of the fighting in sight. Meanwhile, requests for the construction of Nakamura's irrigation canals have begun to come from various parts of the country. In response, Nakamura has launched a new project. The project aims to build a training center to pass on his experience to young technicians recruited from drought-stricken areas throughout the country. Continuing to face the challenge of drought and warfare in Afghanistan, the physician Tetsu Nakamura, 70. Sustaining the dream of the day when people on this soil will once again see green fields and peaceful lives.
American helicopters often pass over the areas where we are working. They fly at the skies in order to kill. We dig the earth in order to live. They employ oppressive machines, while we have the dusty shirts on our backs. There are pleasures and joys here on the ground that they will never know. We know the feelings of those who exult when the parched land obtains water. It is our privilege to witness the exuberant dance of life in the smiling faces of children playing by the river's edge. And this is the foundation of peace.